Greetings, YouTube, Remarkable Republican, here to bring you the truth with truth-flavored bias, and today I'm telling you all about why Tywin Lannister in Game of Thrones is in fact the ultimate homosexual character. Now, there are many openly homosexual characters in the story, however, Tywin is special. Now, George R.R. Martin himself is a homosexual, and Tywin Lannister is sort of the character that he modeled on himself, or at least what he thinks he would be if he lived in a fictional universe. Now, where does the evidence come from? Well, the first hint we get is that we meet Tywin, and he has been widowed for many years, and yet he has never taken a lover. He has no mistress. So far as we know, he never visits prostitutes. And most oddly of all, he doesn't have any bastard children dating back to the time of his youth. This is all highly unusual in the Game of Thrones universe, where nearly everyone has mistresses. Now, moving forward a bit, and now we're in spoiler country, if you really pay attention, his top complaint against Tyrion isn't even his dwarfism, but rather the fact that he's a constant whoremonger. And what it shows is not so much that Tywin has some sort of moral objection to it, I mean, the dude is pretty immoral, I think we can all agree, but that he simply doesn't understand this kind of behavior. Tywin wouldn't understand why someone would want to have sex with a lot of women. Now, all three of Tywin's children are also sexual deviants. Jaime and Cersei, you know, they have some incestuous relations and they have fathered children together. And the thing is, sexual deviance runs in families and they had to get it from somewhere. And since there is no mother character for them since she's been dead for so long, we have to assume that they were taught this kind of immorality by their father Tywin. Now, despite the Lannister incest, and that apparently being a thing that is acceptable both in the Lannister family and the Targaryen family and all of these other families, Tywin never actually sleeps with Cersei or father's children through her to ensure his succession. He also never marries any of his nieces or does any of that kind of thing, even though apparently that would be something that would not be unusual in this universe. Further, in a world where old men, you know, put themselves over on young girls, you look at what's the guy who owns the bridges? I can't think of his name, but what he does, there obviously is no stigma about marrying teenage girls if you're an old man, and yet Tywin does not advance himself on either Arya Stark or Sansa Stark. We also know from Robb Stark and from the context of the show that Tywin is not a skilled general. And in general, not to stereotype too much, we know that homosexuals tend not to be very good at conducting military affairs. And what Tywin looks for is not winning on the battlefield, he looks to ruses which would be very womanly. He likes to win by marriages, and win by personal relationships and by betrayals. He wins by like the high school drama model of power, not by the manly, virtuous model of let's fight in the field and see who the better man is. We also see that he's money hungry, power hungry, and he doesn't really care about glory. And the reason why a lot of people care so much about glory is that glory is the thing that gets you women. And if you're not interested in women, as Tywin obviously is not, then it wouldn't matter. We also see that he's very jealous and petty about getting the credit for defending King's Landing, even though we know for a fact that Tyrion is the primary author of the victory. And this is a very womanly thing, like the way mothers are jealous of their daughters when, you know, they're aging and their daughters are in their prime and much hotter. So this is sort of a thing that a woman would do. And it shows that Tywin is woman-minded and most likely a homosexual. Now, another thing that shows Tywin's homosexuality is that when he's doing his grand marriage scheme in Season 3, he doesn't include himself, even though everyone else is a part of it. And this even includes letting Littlefinger marry Lady Stark's sister, rather than doing it himself, which would have made him both the Lord of the House of Lannister and the Lord of the Vale, uniting two of the Seven Kingdoms, and then creating a grand inheritance for either Joffrey or his other grandson, or someone else. But the reason he doesn't take this deal is obviously because he doesn't do women. Really, what we see is that the man clearly goes well out of his way to avoid any kind of sexual intercourse with women, even when he expects his other children to put their own personal feelings aside and do things they don't want to do. Tyrion is not interested in Sansa Stark, but Tywin asks him to go and father a child by her anyway. And I think the probably the most important piece of evidence, which I saved for last, is that when after Joffrey dies, we hear Tywin complain to Cersei that one of the problems with Joffrey is that he was planning even Tywin's own death. Now, there's not a lot of context in the show about why Joffrey wanted to kill Tywin, and if you actually follow the plot closely, you know that Joffrey is actually very smart about how he uses power to advance himself. So there's got to be a reason why Tywin knew that his goose was cooked. Well, if you recall in season 3, what actually happened is that Joffrey told Margaery that he was thinking about making homosexuality a crime punishable by death. Well, who is homosexual? Who also was in danger of being put to death? Well, Tywin Lannister. It all fits. This is all something which is part of a larger narrative that George R.R. Martin is trying to sneak under people's noses, and that is the obvious truth that Tywin Lannister is, in fact, a homosexual. This has been Remarkable Republican, bringing you the truth with truth-flavored bias, signing out.